Boeing Starliner, which initially promised to create the best crew capsule ever, received billions of dollars from NASA, but ultimately resulted in one of the most disappointing spacecraft of modern times. The most unfortunate aspect is that this situation remains unresolved. Let's discuss it all in today's episode of In Our Studio. It began in 2014 when NASA awarded Boeing a $4.2 billion contract to build the Starliner spacecraft. At the time, NASA faced significant challenges. The space shuttle program had ended in 2011 after the Columbia incident, and the U.S. had no means of sending astronauts into space. For several years, NASA had to purchase seats on Russian Soyuz spacecraft to reach the International Space Station at a cost of approximately $80 million each. As tensions between the United States and Russia escalated, this arrangement became increasingly precarious. To address this, NASA initiated a commercial crew program. When it came time to choose which company to financially support, NASA chose two: Boeing and SpaceX. SpaceX was allocated $2.6 billion, while Boeing received $4.2 billion. Boeing's raider funding stems primarily from NASA's greater confidence in them. With decades of experience in spacecraft and rocket development, including contributions to the Apollo program, the Space Shuttle, and ISS modules, Boeing is a respected figure. SpaceX, on the other hand, is still in its infancy and has yet to demonstrate its capabilities. In 2014, they had only been operating the Falcon 9 rocket for a few years. Boeing committed to completing the spacecraft and beginning astronaut flights in 2017. The capsule, designed to carry up to 7 astronauts, will be launched on an Atlas V rocket manufactured by United Launch Alliance. The capsule is intended to land on solid ground using parachutes and airbags rather than splashing down in the ocean like SpaceX's Crew Dragon. At the time, almost everyone expected Boeing to emerge victorious in this competition. However, things did not go according to plan. Boeing's development process was slow and fraught with management issues. Their multi-layered approval system hampered progress, causing testing to fall short of expectations. In contrast, SpaceX demonstrated agility and speed. They continued to launch, test, and refine with each flight. By the time SpaceX launched its first Crew Dragon mission in 2020, Boeing had yet to complete a successful uncrewed test flight. This was quite embarrassing. NASA had invested $1.6 billion more in Boeing than in SpaceX, yet SpaceX had successfully transported astronauts to the International Space Station while Boeing was still working out fundamental issues. The first significant evaluation for Starliner took place in December 2019. It was intended to be a simple uncrewed trip to the ISS. However, problems arose soon after launch. A malfunction in the software led the spacecraft to believe it was at a different stage of its flight, resulting in an excessive fuel burn too soon. It failed to meet the schedule for reaching the ISS and had to return prematurely. Following over 2 years of setbacks, Boeing made another attempt in May 2022. On this occasion, Starliner successfully arrived at the ISS, but it still encountered issues. Two thrusters malfunctioned during the journey, and engineers uncovered several minor problems post-mission. While it was considered a success nominally, there remained significant repairs and improvements required before it could transport astronauts. Then came the significant challenge. The inaugural crewed mission took place in June 2024. NASA astronauts Sunita Williams and Butch Wilmore were meant to stay at the ISS for about a week and come back without incident. However, Starliner faced numerous complications. 5 out of its 28 small thrusters failed while docking. Furthermore, engineers detected multiple helium leaks in the propulsion system, which were significant issues. Helium is critical for pressurizing the engines and directing maneuvers. Without it, the spacecraft cannot safely execute a return. Initially, NASA and Boeing attempted to minimize the seriousness of the situation, but as engineers conducted more thorough investigations, the problems appeared increasingly severe. The failures of the thrusters were linked to overheating, and the helium leaks proved to be much more extensive than anticipated. By late 2024, NASA concluded that returning the astronauts aboard Starliner was too dangerous. Consequently, they opted for a return via a SpaceX Crew Dragon, which was the very craft Boeing was intended to rival. Starliner returned without any crew. At that moment, Starliner was no longer just behind schedule, it became a significant embarrassment. The astronauts ended up remaining in space for several months beyond the original plan, and public confidence in Boeing's space program plummeted to a record low. By 2025, Boeing had already expended over $2 billion beyond initial projections trying to rectify the project. In contrast, SpaceX was successfully launching Crew Dragon missions consecutively without significant significant complications. What remains perplexing is that NASA has not yet terminated its agreement with Boeing, despite numerous setbacks and delays. Boeing and NASA continue to assert that they are engaging in testing and are preparing for another crewed flight in early 2026, but skepticism is warranted at this stage. The reality is that if this were another firm, NASA would have canceled the contract long ago. Boeing has repeatedly failed to meet deadlines for nearly a decade and has invested billions in addressing issues that should not have arisen. Still, NASA persists in granting them opportunities. One major factor is the influence of politics and lobbying. Boeing allocates millions annually for lobbying efforts and maintains strong ties in Washington. This clout allows them to withstand circumstances that would have led to the downfall of smaller companies. NASA continues to support the partnership, expressing ongoing faith in Boeing's capabilities, despite the absence of a definitive timeline for progress.
Compounding the frustration is NASA's restrictive approach to other companies like SpaceX. For example, in 2021, SpaceX secured a multi-billion dollar contract to build its lunar lander for the Artemis initiative, utilizing its extensive Starship system. Subsequently, in late 2025, NASA announced it would review the contract, implying that SpaceX could potentially lose it due to delays. The NASA administrator has publicly indicated that because SpaceX missed its deadline, the space agency is reintroducing a competition for the same lunar lander contract. He explicitly named Blue Origin as a potential contender. However, Blue Origin is far from ready. Their Blue Moon lander has yet to fly, and the rocket intended to launch it, New Glenn, has yet to reach orbit. Despite this, NASA claims SpaceX is lagging behind. This rationale is difficult to understand. SpaceX has flown 11 missions with Starship, collected a significant amount of data, and has made consistent progress. They are building a new production facility for the Raptor 4 engine and preparing for crewed flight tests. However, NASA believes they are not progressing fast enough. As a result, NASA has distanced itself from SpaceX, a company that has delivered results while retaining Boeing's underperforming Starliner contract after numerous setbacks. This reality makes the whole situation particularly bizarre. Meanwhile, NASA's own launch vehicle, the Space Launch System, or SLS, is experiencing significant failures. The rocket uses reused components from the space shuttle era, such as the same RS-25 engines and solid rocket boosters. These engines were engineered in the 1970s, and NASA has opted to renovate them rather than innovate. A critical issue is their lack of reusability. Each engine costs approximately $100 million and can only be used once. This alone contributes to the high cost of each SLS launch. When NASA first launched the SLS in 2011, the total projected cost was approximately $10 billion. This has now risen to over $30 billion. Furthermore, each launch is now projected to cost over $2 billion. This is more than 10 times more than a single Starship launch, even though Starship can carry a much larger payload and is reusable multiple times. With this in mind, many observers suspect the decision is more political than technical. Boeing and Blue Origin have strong government relationships and invest millions of dollars in lobbying annually, while SpaceX often defies NASA's traditional methods. This may explain why NASA continues to give Boeing leeway despite its ongoing difficulties with Starliner, while simultaneously putting pressure on SpaceX after its substantial achievements. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next time.